Besides being a configuration of comfortable spaces, a building can be seen as a bank of materials and assembled components. A building is also the container for installations and networks of the necessary resources we need for its daily use. Think of energy, water, and fresh air. Furthermore, a building is connected to an environment with specific conditions, such as the climate and human networks. In this video, we will explain how a building is organized and how this influences its life cycle. To unfold the complexity of a building, we will use the shearing layers concept of architect Frank Duffy, which was later elaborated by Stuart Brand in his book How Buildings Learn: What Happens After They're Built, from 1994. In the shearing layers concept, buildings are seen as a collection of components with different life cycle durations. In his book, Brand quoted Duffy as follows: "Our basic argument is that there isn't any such thing as a building. A building properly conceived is several layers of longevity of built components. The concept is based on the ecological idea that there are processes in nature which operate in different time frames. Brand translated this to the organization of a building and came up with the following design imperative. An adaptive building has to allow slippage between the differently paced systems of site, structure, skin, services, space plan, and stuff. Otherwise, the slow systems block the flow of the quick ones, and the quick ones tear up the slow ones with their constant change. Understanding the layer logic of a building enables us to make circular design choices from the start. We will look at the different shearing layers of a building by taking BK City, our almost 100-year-old faculty building, as a case study. BK City is a good example of adaptive reuse, since it has been transformed many times during its lifetime. The Faculty of Architecture and the Built Environment uses BK City since 2008 because a big fire totally burned down the former faculty building. BK City was originally designed as the Faculty of Chemistry. However, because of financial problems and the Second World War, it was never used as such. The building had many temporary users. There were even plans to turn it into a luxurious apartment block. But finally, the fire drove the Faculty of Architecture into its arms. The coordinating architects responsible for the adaptive reuse design of BK City, Braaksma and Roos, decided to bring back the quality and laboratory-like atmosphere of the original chemistry faculty. The idea arose for a building as éducation permanente, in which students can see how the structure, the construction, and the installations work. By walking through the different shearing layers that Brand identified, we hope to answer the question, how did BK City learn? What happened after it was built? The first layer is the site, the geographical setting in which the building is positioned. The site is eternal, states Duffy. Not only spatial aspects play a role, but also climatic, social, cultural, and economic aspects. According to Brand, the site's boundaries and context outlast generations of ephemeral buildings. BK City is part of the oldest area of the campus of Delft University of Technology in the Netherlands. The iconic building has a strong visual relation with all the surrounding university buildings. It serves as a spatial and social anchor to connect the university campus with the rest of the city. As a designer, you can influence the sustainability and comfort of a building by taking the climate of the site into account at the start of the design. The orientation towards the sun, the size of the building's footprint, or the shape of the volume are all aspects that influence the performance of a building and its site. The second layer is the structure of a building. According to Brand, the foundation and load-bearing elements are perilous and expensive to change, so people don't. Structural life ranges from 30 to 300 years, but few buildings make it past 60 for other reasons. The richly ornamented solid brick facade of BK City, containing big window openings for the classrooms, is an important part of the load-bearing structure of the building. In addition, the longitudinal corridor walls and the concrete floor structure form a durable structural frame for the building. Within the brick facade, the structure and the skin of the building coincide, which is often seen in traditional buildings. This makes it even harder to change the structure of the building, which indeed hardly happened over the past 100 years of its lifespan. The third layer is the skin of a building, consisting of the facade and the roof. Brandt explains that external services now change every 20 years or so to keep up with fashion, technology, or for wholesale repair. Recent focus on energy costs has led to re-engineered skins that are airtight and better insulated. We already know that the structure and the skin of BK City coincide within the facade of the building, which makes it hard to change. However, parts of the facade, such as window frames, are non-structural skin elements which have changed a couple of times during the past 100 years. In 1953, the entire attic was converted into general office space for the university. The continuous strip of roof windows dates from this time. Originally, this horizontal roof strip used to have dormer windows at regular intervals. In 2008, the window frames within this same roof strip have been painted, resulting in new colorful window frames. Only a few years later, the window strip has been renewed again, because the design studios within the attic space had too little comfort because of overheating due to the sun. A new window frame system was chosen, which included automatic sunshading. Another example of skin transformation within BK City is the addition of two atriums, covering the outdoor courtyards in between the sections of the building with a large glass roof. The brick facades to which the atriums are connected have transformed into interior walls with this intervention. These examples of BK City show that transformation of the skin happens quite often, mostly under influence of changing user needs or stricter building performance requirements. The fourth layer consists of the surfaces of a building, the so-called working guts, wiring, plumbing, fire extinguishing systems, air conditioning, heating and ventilation systems, as well as elevators and escalators. They wear out or obsolete every 7 to 15 years. Many buildings are demolished early if their outdated surfaces are too deeply embedded to replace easily, Brandt warns. The architects of BK City have chosen for a very flexible strategy to accommodate all the surfaces. All the lower ceilings were taken out, ensuring beautiful high spaces, and all the installations are visibly mounted. If installations need to be repaired or renewed, this can be easily done. The fifth layer consists of the space plan, which represents the interior layout of a building and includes walls, floors, doors, etc. Turbulent commercial space can change every 3 years or so. Exceptionally quiet homes might wait 30 years. In the case of BK City, the biggest challenge was to create education rooms with varying sizes to accommodate different groups of students. The structure of the building fortunately allowed to combine classrooms by leaving out the non-load-bearing division walls. A great example of the transformation of the space plan is the realization of the BK City Library. By taking out all the division walls and ceilings, a generous double-high space is created. The sixth layer consists of the stuff within the building. Brandt sums up: chairs, desks, phones, pictures, kitchen appliances, lamps, hairbrushes, all the things that twitch around daily to monthly. Within BK City, chairs are a good example of stuff that is being moved around the building constantly. Sometimes the chairs are combined in a presentation settings, and sometimes they are used individually at the working tables. So, in this video, we looked at a traditional building of almost 100 years old to understand how a building is organized and how this impacts its life cycle duration. Now that we understand that a building is not one object, but a collection of shearing layers with various life cycle durations, it might be easier to think of a resource production strategy during the design process.